Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do this problem. We're given variables that come from a Poisson distribution and we're asked to use the Rao-Blackwell theorem to estimate the probability that the x's are equal to 0, which is equal to e to the negative lambda. So let's go ahead and get started. The Rao-Blackwell theorem has the following formula. You can write it as delta star t of x is equal to the expected value of delta of x given t of x is equal to t. So basically the idea with Rao-Blackwell is you're going to take an estimate of whatever you're asked to find. So we're asked to estimate e to the negative lambda. We're going to plug in some estimator known as the original estimator, and a lot of the times, well, sometimes you're given what estimator to plug in and it might be just a really bad one. And through Rao-Blackwellization, you're going to find a better estimator. So why is it a better estimator? And also you're going to be conditioning on a sufficient statistic. So t of x equal to t is some sufficient statistic. So the Rao-Blackwell estimator is a better estimator because of its two properties that it has. So the first property that it has is that it's considered a minimum variance estimator. So the variance of delta star t of x is always going to be less than or equal to the variance of delta of x. So whatever estimator you start with, the one that you end up with is always going to have at least that small of a variance as you started with, or many of the time it's going to be less variance. And another property is about the bias. So the expected value for this, whether or not delta star t of x is biased, depends on the original estimator. So if you plug in for your original estimator an unbiased estimator for whatever you're looking for, then the Rao-Blackwell estimator will also be unbiased. And similarly, if you plug in a biased estimator for your original estimator, the Rao-Blackwell estimator will be biased. So if you plug in biased, you get out biased, and if you plug in unbiased, you get out unbiased estimators. Usually you'll learn about Rao-Blackwell first, and then later you'll learn about uniformly minimum variance unbiased estimator, and that's a class of estimators, or sometimes it's just called minimum variance unbiased estimator. And so one way of finding the minimum, and these are good estimators obviously, so one way of finding this category of estimators is by plugging in through the Rao-Blackwell theorem an unbiased estimator. And so when you plug in an unbiased estimator, you'll always get as the output the minimum variance unbiased estimator. Okay, so that was a little background. Now let's go ahead and do this particular problem. So you just have to plug in two things to solve it. The first thing I'm going to do is get my original estimator. So for this one, for these types of problems, a lot of times you can plug in what's called the empirical CDF. So that will look something like this, which is just an average of all the values. In this case, this is a discrete distribution. So the average of all the values of indicator functions. So that kind of models empirically a CDF. In this case, I'm just going to do the first value and say that my estimator is that if x1 is equal to 0, that's an estimator of px is equal to 0. So it's not necessarily a good estimator, but it doesn't have to be because we're going to put it through the Rao-Blackwell formula to make it better anyway. And then the other thing that you need is the sufficient statistic. So to get this, you could, if you don't know it already when you're starting out a problem, you can do maximum likelihood, for example. So if you do something like this, you'll end up getting that it's the sum of xi, or you can just know that already. So for in my case, I already just knew that. So now we just have to plug in and kind of simplify to get the estimator that we want. I'm going to go ahead and plug in our delta of x and t of x into the formula. So that's going to give us e of x1 is equal to 0, given that the sum of xi is equal to t. This is equal to the probability that x of 1 is equal to 0, given that the sum of xi is equal to t. This is just a conditional probability now, so we can use the formula for conditional distributions or conditional probability. So that is equal to the probability of x1 is equal to 0, and the sum of xi is equal to t over the marginal, which is this part, which is the probability of the sum of xi is equal to t. given independence, oh sorry, this should be I is equal to 2 to n. So if we know that x1 is equal to 0, that means that the sum from I is equal to 2 to n, so the rest of the xi's has to be, the sum of that has to be equal to t, because we know that the sum of xi has to be equal to t. So if the first value is 0, that means the rest of the values minus the first value has to be equal to t. So we have independence in the numerator. So with independence, the joint is equal to the product of the marginals. So again, we can simplify that to p of x1 is equal to 0 times the probability that the sum from I equal to 2 to n of xi is equal to t over the probability that the sum of xi is equal to t. And the denominator is for all xi's, not just from 2 to n. So the Poisson has a property where if you have xi's that are distributed Poisson lambda and y's that are distributed Poisson lambda, then the joint is going to be equal to Poisson 2 lambda. So basically when you have multiple Poissons, you just add them as your parameter. So with this property, we can simplify again and, we can basically plug in now what the distribution or what the estimator will look like. So given this information, for the first probability, we can plug in now that this is just equal to e to the negative lambda. For this, using this property, we know that this will be n minus 1 values. So we're going to plug in n minus 1 lambda as the distribution parameter. So that's going to give us negative n minus 1 lambda times n minus 1 lambda to the t over n minus, or sorry, over t factorial. So that's the numerator. And then the denominator is going to be n values. So we're going to have, that's distributed n lambda. So the denominator is going to be e to the n lambda to the t over t factorial. Now we just need to simplify. The t factorials will cancel out. We can cancel out the lambdas here. If we distribute this, this top part is going to be equal to e to the negative lambda. So these cancel out and we're left with n minus 1 over n to the t. T is equal to the sufficient statistic. So it's the sum of xi is equal to t. So we can plug in for our Rao-Blackwell estimator as our final answer, n minus 1 over n to the sum of xi. And this is our final answer. At first, it might look a little bit weird, but if we simplify this, this is actually 1 minus 1 over n to the sum of xi. And we can further simplify that as 1 minus 1 over n times n to the n times the sample mean. And this limit converges to e to the negative sample mean. So since we were asked to find an estimator for e to the negative lambda, it makes sense that we have this as our final answer because this, the limit converges to e to the negative sample mean. And so we're done with this problem.